Today, we are going to talk about PFC, power factor correction modules in PCBs. I will show you how to test them, what their schematic looks like, and how they function. I will explain everything in detail. Today, we will discuss the smart power module for a single-phase boost PFC. This PFC controller is different from the first controller. Today, we will focus solely on this controller on the PCB. I will show you how to test it on the PCB. First, we will apply power and test the PCB. For this, attach a reactor and give a direct 220 or 230 volts supply to the connector while working with safety precautions. First, we need to check the AC voltages, so I will set the multimeter to AC voltage mode. Then, I will apply the electrical supply. One thing to keep in mind is that when you are checking the PCB directly, it might keep turning off due to signal issues. When this happens, the PCB will show an error. What you need to do is test it while it is running and then disconnect the power, switch it off, and reconnect the electrical supply to test it again. Otherwise, it will keep disconnecting repeatedly. Now, I'm going to apply power and it will turn on. See, the green light has turned on and the red light has also turned on, and now it will turn off again. The electricity has been applied. First, we need to check the first two points, which are pin number 27 and 26, where we should get AC voltages. Here, we are getting 239.5 volts AC. Next, what else do we need to check? Since the rectification is done inside the module, the rectifier is built in, I will show you where else to check. We should get 13 to 20 volts here, as this is the negative side, and there is also an overvoltage resistor installed here. At pin number 25, we should get DC voltage, so I will switch the multimeter to DC mode. Now we should get DC voltage, and here we are getting 252 volts DC, which is perfect. Next, we will check the next point to confirm if the resistance is working correctly or not. Let's check the voltage here, and it looks fine. You can also check the resistance directly. Now see how the system is working with the reactor. The DC voltage, which was between 20 to 30 volts, is returning from the reactor. Now the next point we will check is pin number 21 and 22, where we should get boosted voltage. I will turn the unit on again, and now you will see that the negative side remains the same, while the positive side has been boosted. Here we are getting 333 volts, which is exactly right. This confirms that our PFC booster is working perfectly. In this, I want to inform you about the enhancements made. A single package has been prepared to save space, and additionally, the purification process and PFC have been improved for better performance. It has also been made more sensitive so that if any issues arise, it is easier to protect the system from potential problems. Now, let me explain what's inside. In the modules that are already being manufactured by the company, on one side, there is an IPM, a diode, an IGBT, and a rectifier. However, in this new board, the company has combined the IGBT, diode, and rectifier into one place. The advantage of this is that you can't install separate sensors on each component to check for overheating or any other issues. The benefit of having a single package is that a thermistor has been added, which helps detect heat. The thermistor continuously monitors the system's heat, and if it starts overheating, it shuts the system down to keep it safe. In contrast, in the other circuit, if any of these components overheats, it's difficult to quickly protect the system. Often, in such cases, the IPM gets damaged, or the fault moves towards the compressor, or something like a chopper switch gets damaged, which can cause greater damage to the system. Now, we will test it without electricity. However, if you have recently removed the circuit from the system, you need to wait 15 to 20 minutes to allow the capacitors to discharge. After that, set your multimeter to diode mode and place the negative probe on the negative terminal and the positive probe on all the high side points. When I place the probe on pin number 27, there should be no value displayed, and there should be no value shown on any other point either. Now, if we reverse the probes, you can see that when I place the probe, we are getting a voltage drop of 0.580 volts. On the next point, we will also see a value, and on the third point, the value will increase and even double. We should not get any voltage on this point if the reactor is not installed. On pin number 21 and 22, we are getting a value of 0.8, which means everything is working perfectly. Now, look at the diagram I have prepared. When I checked it for the first time, pin 26 should have neutral, and pin 27 should have phase. After that, they get rectified, and as soon as rectification occurs, positive rectified voltages should appear on pin 25, and negative on pin 17 and 20. Next, you can see there is an IGBT installed here, which is attached to the neutral side. When pin 5 turns on, it passes through the diode and moves toward the positive side, and this is how the function works. Additionally, a thermistor is installed on pins 9 and 10. For the remaining pins, you can refer to the datasheet, which will make things much clearer. The module number is FPAB30BH60, so you can check the datasheet using this number, and it will help you easily understand what this component is. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.